What caused you to decide to tell your stories and using Rudy as the backdrop for it?
Well, I believe Rudy is relatable to all children because I don't really mention an age or a gender very often. So I've found with telling my stories to all the children that they do relate to Rudy, and then especially the medical ones.
Mm-hmm.
He's kind of a small dog, and if the children can see that a little guy like him can go through these situations, well, he's, you know, strong and he's able to do it, and it makes them feel more empowered so that they can do it too.
This is something that, gee whiz, even for an adult, it could be very informative.
Well, thank you. I appreciate you saying that because it is written for children, but adults have learned from these books too. They've come up to me after a program or something and said that they didn't realize all of this was involved with dialysis or how dialysis worked. Many of them didn't, you know, even know that we have two kidneys in our body and we only need one. And so when we talk about the nutrition and how the dialysis machine works, they were very interested in it, and they said that they had learned a lot, too. And it's something that you had touched on earlier. It does take the fear out of the whole process. So I figure if you can take away the fear, then it's not as scary. And because education is so important. If you know what you're getting into, then it does seem less scary, and that does take the fear,
mm-hmm.
some of the fear out of it.
And Boomer is trying to talk to Rudy to find out what it's like in heaven on the other side of life, and there's just this wonderful conversation that goes between the two of them.
Yeah, that's something that just kind of happened one day. I was sitting in my spot where I usually do my writing, and Boomer had come up to me and put his head on my lap, and I petted him, and I could feel his head turn and look at a picture of Rudy that I always have sitting right by me. And I just started talking to Boomer, and I said, I don't know, Boomer. I don't know why Rudy had to go to heaven. And all of a sudden, it's just like a conversation happened. It was unbelievable. So I just started jotting things down. And I know it was all in my mind, but it felt like it was really, really, really happening in my heart and in my mind, and the Boomer stayed next to me, and all of a sudden, this book came out.
And then the comment, many men in kilts walked around blowing into something that looked like Ollie, my toy octopus. And those instruments are called bagpipes, Rudy is told. And then it's about music and dancing, and then there is a band that plays, and there's a man with green hair that says, there is a wee poodle, his name it is Rudy. He hops on his back legs. He is such a cutie. He spins and he twirls. Oh, my, what a beauty. The crowd, they all yell, it's Rudy, oh, tootie. It's just
That's
adorable.
That's his song, yes.
That is his song. Stacy Ray Weibel, you are an incredible woman. I compliment you, and where many others maybe would not have the inspiration and the ability to move forward, you definitely have done it through a lot of obstacles, and it's been a delight having you as a guest today. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for having me, and I truly do believe that everything happens for a reason.
I can
it just takes a while to figure that reason out.